was seen earlier. Active acquired immunity on the basis of a type of cells. It is of two different types. Yesterday we have discussed first type of active acquired immunity, that is CMIS. CMIS means cell mediated immune system. And this immune system is operated by T lymphocytes. This immune system is operated by T lymphocytes. The second type of cells which are involved in immunity, which provides human immunity, Now this immunity becomes what as antibody mediated immune system. Antibody mediated immune system. And this antibody mediated immune system, it is provided by second type of lymphocytes. Now these lymphocytes are called as B lymphocytes. Now antibody or immunoglobulin. Antibody is also called as immunoglobulin. Immuno means which protects the body from different infectious agents. That is an immune system. So we have taken the word immuno from immune system. And globulin means it is a type of protein which is present in a blood plasma. So whatever antibodies they are present, they are also called as immunoglobulin. Now these antibodies, they are the complex glycoprotein. All the antibodies are complex glycoprotein. Now all antibodies, they are proteins. All the antibodies, they are proteins. But all proteins, they are not antibodies. The GK antibodies body, they are given chemically several antibodies as well. Proteins असतात पण बॉडी मध्ये बरेचसे प्रकारचे प्रोटीन्स आहेत होतात सगळे प्रोटीन्स हे अँटीबॉडीज असतात सो ऑल प्रोटीन्स सॉरी ऑल अँटीबॉडीज दे आर दी प्रोटीन्स फॉर ऑल प्रोटीन्स आर नॉट दी अँटीबॉडीज सो अँटीबॉडी और इम्युनोग्लोबुलिन इज अ कॉम्प्लेक्स टाइप ऑफ ग्लायकोप्रोटीन प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द बॉडी इन रिस्पॉन्स टू एंटीजन Response to antigen. Antigen may be any foreign substance. Antigen may be any foreign substance which enters into your body and it stimulates the body for production of an antibody. So such type of chemical substance produced in response to antigen. Such type of chemical substance is called as antibody. So whenever any antigen it enters into your body, now this antigen it stimulates helper T cells. And this helper T cells, in turn, it stimulates B lymphocytes. It stimulates B lymphocytes. Once stimulated by helper T cells, these B lymphocytes, they produce their clones. Now these clones, they are also called as plasma cells. B lymphocytes, they produce their clones. These cells, they are also called as plasma cells. And each plasma cell, it produces 2000 molecules of antibodies per second. In turn, each plasma cell produces 2000 molecules of antibodies per second. Now, these antibodies which are produced, if you observe the structure of antibody, it just appears like a Y shape. Capital Y shape structure. Each antibody, it consists of 4 polypeptide chain. It consists of 4 polypeptide chains. You can see figure, first chain, second chain, third chain, as well as fourth chain. So each antibody consists of 4 polypeptide chain. Now, of these 4 polypeptide chain, if you take the formula H2N, the formula for 4 polypeptide chain is H2 as well as N2. H, it represents heavy chain, and N, it represents light chain. H means heavy chain. Now, from these 4 polypeptide chain, 2 chains, they are long. two chains they are long. Now these chains they are called as heavy chains, for also called as an H chains. And two chains they are short. Now this chain is called as light chain, but also called as heavy chain. The heavy chain, it is composed of 440 amino acids. It's composed of 440 amino acids. While light chain is composed of here about 220 amino acids. Normally, two H chains and two light chains. The number of amino acids there is, that is light chain. The number of amino acids there more, such as it is called as now each chain, it consists of two regions. As shown in the figure, first it is constant region and second region is called as variable region. Each chain consists of two regions. First constant region, second region is called as variable. If you observe the figure, now this region is called as constant region and this region is called as a variable. Now constant region means the region which consists of similar sequence of amino acids. The region which consists of a similar sequence of amino acids, such region is called as constant region. But just doni chain mode amino acids sequence is same. Acha region apko bata raha hu constant region. As a region which consists of different sequence of amino acids, such type of region is called as variable. So region having same sequence of amino acids, constant region. Region having different sequence of amino acids is called as variable. So heavy chain, it consists of about 440 amino acids. It consists of about 220 amino acids. Now out of these 440 amino acids of a heavy chain, one to near about 208, they are responsible for the formation of a constant region, and 209 to 440. Responsible for the formation of a variable region. Okay? So constant and variable region having same sequence, constant having different sequence. Now each polypeptide chain of this antibody, they remain attached to each other with the help of two sulfide bonds. Now this is also called as disulfide bond. So these four polypeptide chains, they are held together with the help of disulfide bonds. And along with the protein, there is the presence of a molecules of carbohydrate. That's why antibody is called as a complex glycoprotein. Protein molecules are associated with the molecules of a carbohydrate, which is also called as glycoprotein. The antibodies which are produced in the body, there are different types: IgG, IgA, IgM, IgE and IgD. Body produces five different types of antibodies which perform different functions in the body. First it is IgG, second it is IgA, third it is IgM, fourth it is IgE, and fifth it is IgD. A simple technique to remove these antibodies: game. I was game. मुझे बोलते हैं मदर game खेला. I was game. G-A-M-E. IgG, IgA, IgM, IgE, IgD. Okay, so there are five different types of antibodies which are produced inside the body. Now these antibodies which are produced, now these antibodies, they are responsible to fight against the antigen. And these antibodies, they fight against the antigen mainly by three different methods. First, agglutination. Second is called as opsonization, and third is called as neutralization. Now these antibodies, they bind to the surface of antigen. Antibodies, they bind to the surface of an antigen, and they are responsible to kill the antigen by a process. That process is called as cell lysis. Killing of a cell is also called as cell lysis. Second, opsonization. The antibody, it forms a coat on the antigen and it attracts the macrophages as well as monocyte to phagocytose that particular antigen. And third type, the antibodies which neutralize the effect of toxins which are produced by the antigens. Such type of mechanism of killing the antigen is called as neutralization. Now, on constant region of polypeptide chain, now this antibody, it consists of an antigen binding site. It consists of an antigen binding site. The site from where antibody it binds to the antigen, that site is called as antigen binding site. And antigen it binds to this antibody in the form of lock and key fashion. Lock as well as key fashion. Now antibody it consists of lock mechanism and antigen which binds to the antigen binding site. It consists of key mechanism. So shape of binding of antigen to antibody it is also called as lock and key fashion. Okay, so this is a mechanical substance produced by the beta lymphocytes on the body, or B lymphocytes of the body, which provides humoral immunity by protecting our body from antigen by production of complex glycoprotein. The complex glycoprotein is called as antibody. Is it clear? Yes. Any problem? Okay.